Hi, my name is Nikos Petrelis and in this video I'm going to describe you how I have ported the deformable shape tracking applications that are the repository is the one in GitHub, as you can see here. The applications are appropriate for face shape alignment, training of landmark alignment in general, and other very useful applications in image processing and machine learning. So this repository is a little bit old, and the instructions given about how to build from source are very poor. And you will probably have problems in directly trying to install the deformable shape tracking package unless you are very familiar with the CMake utility and be able to customize the CMake files and understand whatever is in these scripts. I'm going to describe you a more a slightly different approach, where we are going to compile the source code of the deformable shape tracking package in the Visual Studio environment. And specifically, I'm going to use Visual Studio 2019. There is also Visual Studio 2022, but I do not have installed this environment in my PC. So the first thing you have to do is make sure that you have installed the Visual Studio and preferably the version 2029, Visual Studio 2029 download. You will be directed to the Microsoft Visual Studio link. If you like to install the older version to be fully compliant with what I show in my video here, you have to move to older downloads, and you will find 2019. And you may start downloading. You will be directed to give your account. If you do not have an account, you may create one. It's free, so it does not have any cost. And within this page here, you will choose the Visual Studio Community download. It will download a small setup file. And then you will be directed to select the modules that you like to include. In our case, the most important is to select C++ support, because all the DEST library that we will compile is in C++. Okay, so I don't describe further how you will install Visual Studio. You may require several gigabytes on your hard disk in order to install it. The next thing you have to install before trying to compile the DEST package is the OpenCV library. I suggest you follow the instructions given here in this link. In the comments of YouTube, and in the description of this YouTube video, you will find this link. It's the one that worked. There are some other alternative options on how to install OpenCV, but one I tried earlier using VC package did not work. So I suggest follow these instructions shown in this video here. You will be directed to install from the OpenCV releases. The release shown here is 4.240, but I tried a more recent one. I tried OpenCV 4.5.4, and by choosing Windows, you will be directed to select the directory where to install these files. These are pre-compiled for Windows. I do not store it again, but I will show you where I have installed it, because the directory and the folder I installed it will be used in our definitions later. So you can see that under my C hard disk, I created OpenCV, and then these are the subdirectories of the file that you will download from here if you uncompress the file that you download. So within here you will find some sources, but we will directly use the already built files. We will use the include directory, and we will also use the libraries within x64 and vc15. You will see them later in my Visual Studio environment. Having installed already the OpenCV and the Visual Studio, you can move forward and install the package itself, the dest package. However, you will also need to install the Eigen library here. So the deformable shape tracking package can be found in this path. So if you type this HTTP address here, you will be directed in this site, in this repository. You will simply download this as a zip file, and I have placed them, for example, as you can see, here in a directory under users, my name, source, dest. Users, my name, source, dest. Here I have placed the downloaded RAR file, which is called dest master, and I uncompressed it, so I got this subdirectory. You won't see these two files here. You will see a subdirectory with the same name, dest master, but I renamed it to just dest. And under this file, you will see under this folder, you will see the same structure. Then you will see here from the Git from the Git repository. You will see some additional files in my directory, because I have tried to run the CMake files, but I had several difficulties and finally failed to install all the applications correctly. That's why I'm also showing you this one here. So, except from the dest directory, I have also downloaded Eigen library. This library does not have to be compiled or built. You just have to include the appropriate paths. So I selected the release 3.3.8, which is, I guess, a stable release that I had used in the past. I have uncompressed it, and this folder was generated. However, whatever was in this folder, I have moved it side by side within this working directory to the dest directory that I showed you earlier, and I renamed it simply Eigen. So remember that in the working directory we have two folders, one folder for the dest repository and one folder with the Eigen repository. Now, at this point, we can move on to the Visual C++, Visual Studio C++ environment. I have already installed some two of the several applications that are included in the dest package. And I will show you in the next video the structure of these projects, how you can create them, and how you can extend them, as I will do, with another application from the example folder of the deformable shape tracking package.